Senior from Hawaii, Justin Yen, has this putt for par to remain at 4-under, and he does maintain a two-shot lead. Meanwhile, Pepperdine sophomore William Mao playing his second shot into the par 4 17th from 79 yards out. And takes the safe route with that pin tucked along the right side, so he'll have a putt for birdie. Justin Yen leading the way by two shots. Difficult conditions at Positiempo at the Western Intercollegiate. Designed in 1929 by the great Alistair McKenzie, Positiempo Golf Club has played host to the Western Intercollegiate. This is the 74th edition, as hosted by San Jose State. With San Jose some 30 miles from Positiempo, such a rich tradition in golf history. Ken Venturi, a two-time winner of the Western Intercollegiate here at Positiempo. And last year, San Jose State's Sean Yu lost in a five-hole playoff, trying to win the individual title for San Jose State for the first time since 1996 at the Southwestern. San Diego State University, the winner of the Southwestern Invitational Team Championship. Some of the best in college golf, ready to take stage this week. Proudly presents first round action of the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Topgolf and by Titleist. Positiempo Golf Club, located about 15-minute drive from Water's Edge in Santa Cruz. What a gorgeous setting it is in this famed venue. So many great players have competed here in their college days. The Western Intercollegiate started as a place for players to play in 1947 during their spring break. Some of the top college players. And this field has had some of a who's who of competitors over the years. You'll see some of the best in college golf. This par 70 playing just over 6,600 yards. As we take a look at the tournament format for the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Titleist. 13-team field, Arizona and UCLA forced to withdraw. 12 individuals, 54-hole stroke play. Each team counts 5 of 6 scores. And the individual medalist receives the blue letterman jacket as respect for the designer Alistair McKenzie, which was first awarded in 2008. Justin Yen of Hawaii, a senior, currently leading the way by two shots over RJ Mankey of Pepperdine and William Mao. Obviously, the golf course proving to be a wonderful test, and we will display it and dictate it throughout the course of the day. Kirk Byram has a wonderful illustration of what the players are dealing with on the green complexes, especially hole 16. Washington leads the way. They are even and done for the day. Pepperdine with a couple holes to play, just a shot back, followed by USC and BYU. So glad you can join us for the Western Intercollegiate. Bob Popple along with Kurt Byram, Steve Burkowski calling the action with Billy Ray Brown out on the golf course. RJ Mankey playing his final hole of the day, the par 3 18th, 168 yards.
Brutally slow going up the slope. Look at how hard he had to hit it. Still, good putt, but still couldn't get it all the way to the hole. Tremendous amount of slope in this green as well. We're going to say that a lot, by the way. All these greens, very undulating, slopey.
Let's go over to 15 and welcome in Steve Burkowski.
Hello there, Bob Papa. Tee shot on the way for Justin Yen from Hawaii at the short par 3. Just 122 yards today. Sliver of green on that left-hand side with today's hole location. So work to do for Yen as we go up to the green at 17. Pepperdine's William Mao has this for birdie. Billy Ray Brown down there watching.
Thank you, Burko. Currently 2-under par. This is really quick coming down the hill left to right. Nice try there. Couldn't be aggressive with that one.
RJ Mankey has this putt for par to finish off his round with a 2-under 68. And that has him 2 off the lead. take a look at the individual leaderboard, and Justin Yen currently at 4 under. Mankey in with his 2 under. Mao with one hole to play is also at 2 under par. And Kurt, when you take a look at the scores, not a great surprise that, you know, 4 under leads, but most of the field is, you know, in that range of even par or so.
This golf course stands up against these Division I players very, very well as Thor Bjornsson goes off at 18.
Go in.
Good shot. That's up on that tier. That should stay there. He's going to have a really good look at birdie.
Go back over to 15.
From one par three to another, Justin Yen second from the greenside bunker.
Just got to hope it's not plugged in there.
Played here a couple years ago, finished tied for 58, including a final round 69.
William Mao on the tee at 18. We're going to follow his tee shot with Top Tracer technology powered by Top Golf.
One of the sophomore here is comes with a lot of talent. He'd like to copy the tee shot of Thor Bjornsson here, trying to keep it on that shelf on that left-hand side, 168 yards downhill.
Boy, good luck with that next one.
Oh, my goodness. Conditions are absolutely perfect right now. Chris, you said it. I mean, 6,600 yards, 1929 when this course was designed, and it will challenge the best of players, not only in college, but in the world itself.
It certainly can. You throw in a little bit of wind around here, which makes those approach shots even that much more difficult. And it's really tough to get close to the hole. You have to be very, very precise. And, you know, it helps. We were talking earlier, Billy Ray, you know, it helps to drive the ball in the fairway as well. So you have total control over it from there.
I think that's a must to try to position yourself on the greens where you have a chance.
Yep.
Now Highsmith, left-hander, junior at Pepperdine. Comes in a little steep at the ball, but it hits it very high and spins it a lot here, so you have to be able to control that. Yeah, it could come off that hill there. This
might
could
go
be good.
In. Might go in.
Oh,
now
well,
stop.
It's got to stop. It might catch that ridge.
It's gone. Going to have 50, 60 feet coming back. That's not unusual. That's going to happen. And it's tough for players to take that mentally sometimes. William Mao making his way towards that 18th green.
Yeah, and the Walker Cup is back in the U.S. and being contested at Seminole Golf Club in Juno Beach. 10 of the best male amateur golfers from the United States will face off against the team from Great Britain and Ireland. Battle begins May the 8th and 9th right here on golf. You see William Mao, part of that team, representing the United States. Seminole Golf Club in Juno Beach. What a venue, what a setting for the 48th Walker Cup. And you will see it right here on golf, beginning on May the 8th and 9th. And
Chicago Golf Club, now Seminole. It is what an honor to be on that team and be able to participate in that.
Let's go over to 17.
Pick up Joey Versich from Pepperdine, his second at the par four. Pretty good one considering that whole location as we drop back to 15. See if Justin Yen from Hawaii can make this for par, remain bogey free, and stay 4 under for the day. 122 yards, Kurt. That's all it is.
A little chip gap wedge, and if anything, it's got a little helping breeze behind him. So they don't have to be long holes to be difficult, do they?
No, they don't. So Yen drops to 3 under. His lead now just a single shot. Take a look at the Hawaii Rainbows. Ron Miyashiro, longtime head coach. Got four seniors on the squad of six here. They won the Pearl Collegiate Classic, a little bit earlier in 2021. And you know, one of the highlights for every team in the field this week, but especially Hawaii, to be able to come over here and be a part of this each and every year.
Now we take you back over to 18. We talked about William Mao being part of that Walker Cup team. Difficult shot, Billy Ray, here at 18.
Yeah, very, very difficult shot. The lie sitting down. First thing with this head coach, Coach Beard here, trying to see where he can land this ball. He's going to have to land it past the hole and to the left and let it come back down. But given that lie sitting down, it's a little bit of guesswork how it's going to come out of this lie. If he can get this within 8 to 10 feet, it would be a spectacular play from this left-hand side.
If he keeps it on that top shelf where the hole is located over there to his right, it's a really good shot anywhere on that top shelf.
Well, if you get a little greedy here and the ball can hang up in some of this ryegrass, it's pretty sticky. It's about 2 inches around these greens, and you have to be very lucky to pitch it through it. He's coming back down. It should start to come back downhill, but it's going to come off that ridge, Kurt.
It sure is. Out of position with that tee shot. That pulled short iron that he hit in there went a long way, and it put him in a position where it was almost impossible. Without taking massive risk, it was going to be really tough to get that ball close.
Kurt, would you say on 18 with the tee shot that your best leave or your best mistake is if you hit it short in that front part, so you have just a hard uphill putt that you probably can get a two putt for make your par?
Yeah, where Highsmith is right now putting his ball down on the green, that's if you land anywhere in the middle of the green, that's where your ball is going to end up. That's the safe play, but you're talking about it plays downhill. You're talking 168 minus the downhill, you're talking 161 yards. Some of these guys hit no more than a 9-iron from 161, so it's impossible for them to aim away from that back shelf. So they're going to try to take it on. But if you don't get it all the way on top with a little bit of spin, it's not going to stay there.
Very interesting play here. Now, Highsmith will be next to play for Pepperdine. And unusual look that he's coming back up this hill, Kurt. I got a suspicion that he's going to try to actually putt this ball past the hole and let it come back down the slope. And if you're a coach like Michael Beard right there in the action, it's got to be difficult to be able to coach your players right now because there's so many things can happen here at Pasatiempo where it can distract the player. And certainly I think coaching is going to be a big part this week.
I think the mental side, too. You know, you hit shots that you think are going to end up pretty good, and then the next thing you know, you're 60 feet from the hole, like Highsmith is, and then he's got a tough two-putt. Darn good.
That's very, very good.
Another Pepperdine wave here at 17. Joey Versich pick up a birdie. Just have to be so defensive on those putts, Kurt.
You sure do.
Now William Mao for his par at 18.
He certainly learned that line and the speed from his teammate Hightower.
Well, he had it online. Mao, first team All-America his freshman year. Amazing freshman year at Pepperdine.
Coming off the bogey just in the end on the tee at 16.
It's not a long par four. You're just trying to get it over the top of that hill, let it run down the hill and into the fairway there. At 16. 16 is only 396. Oh. That's where that ball will end up. Be in good shape.
Stanford's Carl Phillips for his birdie.
I mean, off that slope, coming downhill, turning to the right. This pairing here, two freshmen from Stanford. two players. Conrad Ray. Future looks bright with these two freshmen.
So Phillips with a 73 now. Michael Thorbjornsson, also of Stanford, after hitting a wonderful shot in.
It really was, but the mindset here now, even though he's on the proper level, you still have to be very cautious. This putt getting away from you, just get it started. It's definitely going to turn back to the left.
Boy, what a two that was.
Wow. And he agrees.
And we will see Stanford and Pepperdine in our TV window tomorrow. Heck of a birdie, a heck of a round. One over 71. Now Mao for his bogey at 18.
It's a perfect example of what Kirk spoke of at the top of the show. If you get out of position on any one of these holes here at Pasatiempo, making par is difficult. Best remedy for that, Kurt, is just take your medicine and move on.
Yeah, well, he'd be happy to make this putt for bogey right now. That's
no doubt.
Well, Kurt, close to 6 feet.
Kurt, let's go back to, you know, the original design, Alistair McKenzie. We just finished the Masters this past weekend, another McKenzie design. It's all about position and putting yourself in the right spot to then attack the green in the right spot.
Yeah, and you have to be a good iron player. You have to be good on those approach shots to put yourself in those areas on the green to have any chance to make a putt. You make a little bit of a mistake and these greens will punish you.
Highsmith par finishes with a 2 over 72, and now with that double at 18, finishes it even, 3 off the lead. Pepperdine currently in second place in the team competition. All right, over at 16, our leader in the individual, Justin Yen, playing his second.
Off a slight downhill lie here. That hole location tucked in that middle shelf up against that right bunker. That's coming back off the green. There's a huge slope right there.
I can't wait until a little later in the show, Kurt, when you take our viewers through the actual slope.
It's crazy.
That 16 presents. When you look at it from above, it doesn't look nearly as dastardly as it is up close and personal. It's the 74th playing of the Western Intercollegiate. Today's coverage is brought to you by Topgolf, Titleist, the number one ball in golf, Bushnell Golf, and the Pro XE. Experience the best. Stiefel, investment services since 1890. Through what the players are facing out there.
Well, Justin Yen is looking at it right now. I'm standing pretty close to where he was. This gives you an idea how much slope there is. So that hole location over the right. So I threw it up. I used the backstop here, right? And I'm trying to get it to stop somewhere around the hole, but it carries a little too much speed. If it carries too much speed, it'll come past that and right off the green. I think that's the proper shot for Yen to try to play. If you try to hit the perfect shot just to the top of that tier with a little spin and you don't hit it perfectly, it's coming right back to your feet. So I think you use that backstop here. Oh, he went into the hill with a little bump and run. How about that shot? What a great shot that was. He got creative.
You should have tried that one.
That was pretty skillful right there. I'm not sure with my throwing action I could have done that. Very nice.
Barkley Brown of Stanford, sophomore, on the tee at 18.
Oh, boy. You know what? That's not terrible, though. He can use the slope to get that close.
Justin Yen, currently at 3 under, has a one-shot lead and a short par putt coming up at 16. And I'm glad to be joined by Kurt Byram. And Kurt, you know, we were here 2 years ago and we were following Cal's Colin Morikawa. Next thing you know, he's winning a major as a professional golfer. The depth of talent on the men's college golf side is something that we're going to get a look at this week.
It's really good. At this Division I level, it's really good. By the way, Colin Morikawa did not win here that week. It wasn't long after that he won his first PGA Tour event. So it just is an indicator of the quality of golf you see out here. If you're good enough to be on a Division I school that's ranked inside the top 30 or 40 in the nation, you're a really good player, and it's really fun to watch these young men.
What about the test that these players will face here this week? We talk so much about the modern game and the length, yet this golf course cannot be overpowered.
It's incredible that a golf course designed by Alistair McKenzie back in 1929 can still offer a challenge to players who hit it well over 300 yards these days. But it does. And a lot of it starts with the greens. The greens are very undulated, very slopey, and they create an amazing challenge for these kids. If their approach game, their iron game, isn't pretty precise, they're going to end up a long way from the hole. The only way to get it close is to really understand this golf course, hit it in those bowls where the hole is located. And that's the only way to get it close. If you miss, you could be 50, 60 feet, or you could be off the green.
Take a look at the team leaderboards of the 74th Western Intercollegiate. Washington with a 4-shot lead over Pepperdine, 5 over Cal. USC and San Diego State early in their day, currently at 7 over par. Let's see Colorado State, Texas, El Paso, and Hawaii. Over to 17.
Where we find Matt Gunson from UC Irvine, his second for the junior, currently a couple over par in this opening round. Safely aboard, he'll take that after that tee shot, and we take a deeper look at the capsule for the Anteaters. Paula Smith, the athletic director there, and a relatively young team, 3 freshmen on their squad for the 6 team members making their appearance, 8-time Big West Conference champions under head coach Paul Smolinski. Anteaters back here at Pasa Tiempo in 2021 as we head back out to the action at 18.
Second shot for Barkley Brown at 18. And Kurt, it is fun to watch. You don't think that this is the worst leave in the world. You played here as a college student. You know what it's like.
I came here. That was back a long time ago, obviously. The University of New Mexico, I was part of that team, and we came here, and I'm pretty sure I was a freshman, and Pasa Tiempo beat me up pretty good. I had a bunch of 3 putts, had a lot of trouble with these greens.
Talked about William Mao being a member of the United States Walker Cup team.
Cheers, guys.
Nicely done, which will be contested at Seminole May 8th and 9th. Let's take a look at the Great Britain and Ireland team. See Barkley Brown of Stanford, one of those players that will be competing for Captain Stuart Wilson. Pepperdine's Dylan Minetti has a birdie putt at 18. Ethan Ng of Stanford, junior, has this putt left for par. Ng, a multi-sport athlete. Ethan Ng, former swimmer at Packer Collegiate Institute. I didn't know our producer, Brant Packer, had an institute. More like institutionalized.
It's got some hard left in it as it dies around the hole.
Oh. Penning. Can't believe he didn't make it. Let's go over to 17.
Henry Fitzhugh from Cal Irvine getting ready to go off the tee here at the par four. Billy Ray Brown's caught up with this group before.
Well, thank you, Berko. It's a very difficult driving hole. You'll see a lot of players miss to the right. The fairway slopes in that direction. But out of bound comes immediately up that left-hand side. A young freshman there. We've seen a lot of freshmen this week here at Pasatiempo.
It's a good angle there. It's tough from that right rough, but that left rough, he has a chance.
You know, Justin Yen going to follow that one up.
Yeah, I'm very impressed after the little pitch, Kurt, that he played there at 16. It showed a lot of skill and a lot of nerve to play that shot.
Sure did.
When picking up, it's back into the player's face. The tee shot plays slightly back up the hill. It's up the right-hand side, you'll see the majority of tee shots up that right. Doesn't give you a very good angle where that hole located on that right-hand side today.
Well, you want to find out how one of the LPGA's toughest competitors plays to win in the new series Lessons with a Champion Golfer with Morgan Pressel. Exclusively on Golf Pass. Watch it now and try 7 days for free. Back at 18, Barkley Brown for his par. Barkley Brown. I like it. I like the personality.
Let's go over at 11. San Jose State. They are freshman. Caleb Shetler. This will be quick, Kurt.
It sure will. It should turn right pretty hard as well. Oh, just about that much. What a great, yeah.
We're seeing those reactions from everyone. Whether it's for a par, a birdie, a bogey, they know how challenging Pasatiempo can be as the opening round of the Western Intercollegiate continues. Washington in with even par. Great team total for the Huskies. We're back with more from Santa Cruz, California, right after this.
We're back at the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Topgolf. Campus of San Jose State, located 30 miles south of Pasatiempo and San Jose State University, over 35,000 students on campus, and the oldest public university on the West Coast. Let's go over to 11.
Yeah, speaking of the Spartans, Bob, see if they can rattle off another birdie here at 11. Freshman Carl Corpus. How about those threes by Shetler and Corpus at 11? Gets Carl to one under par. Make our way back ahead to the 17th. Tournament leader, Justin Yen, maybe a little tree trouble here.
Yeah, definitely so. This senior from Hawaii has got a decision to make. You're going to have to go out to the left. Given the hole location on the right-hand side, he's got to try to miss left here. Try to use some of that slope up the left-hand side. See if he can, it'll come back down to the right, trying to use that slope.
Right idea.
Yeah, really not much you could do from there. He was forced to go out to the left given the hole location.
San Diego State's Caleb Bruce, senior. Our first look at the 10th today. Par 4, 440 yards.
There are some trees down that right side that hang out a little bit. Interesting to see here if he has to deal with those. Look back up there. See those limbs that kind of hang out there? That hole location's on the right side of the green as well. So he may be dealing with those a little bit, as well as trying to figure out how he's going to stop it coming out of this rough.
And, Kurt, it illustrates the point that you've made. We just saw it with Justin Yen at 17. If you're out of position, that's where this golf course really can get you.
It really can, because it makes these approach shots just that much tougher to get anywhere near the flagstick. And in his case, if he's dealing with those limbs up above there, just on the green somewhere. Looking up like he's going to go high.
5 of the 6 count for the team score.
Got up and over. Let's see. Now just stay there. Some slope that'll feed this off to the left. But considering the limbs that he was dealing with, that's pretty well done.
San Diego State won the team competition here in 1960. And
you could hear them a couple times now. We've heard them. There they are. There's turkeys out there. Saw them earlier there on the 10th hole.
They're safe. Thanksgiving isn't for about 7 months, so they'll be okay. How about par 5, 13, Finnegan Tilley from California? That was for the outright lead. That was an eagle putt.
Yeah, this par 5, 13th is not a long par 5. Very reachable for these players, but that second shot needs to be really good to have any chance to make eagle, especially today with that back left corner that they've got the hole cut in.
Back-to-back birdies for Tilley, so he joins Yen at the top. Leading the way at 3-under. And speaking of Justin Yen, let's pick him up at 17.
Well, he definitely has his hands full. We saw his tee shot missed to the right behind the trees. Played a smart shot out to the left. This little pitch shot's coming off the side slope. Ball's going to be well below his feet. But it's got a huge amount of break from left to right. Also has ton of speed as it comes back down the hill. It's doable though because he has plenty of green to work with. Ball not sitting that bad. Definitely won't come out with any spin whatsoever. Yeah, that's a great indication there how fast it is coming across this green from left to right. Now a lot of work left to save this par for Yen.
Yeah, third straight hole. Yen's been scrambling, unable to get it up and down from the bunker at 15. Nice par save at 16. He'll try to do the same there at 17 to remain at 3-under, tied at the top alongside Finnegan Tilley. RJ Mankey in with 2-under 68 for Pepperdine. You see Derek Hitchner there with a little I next to his name. Some individuals in the field this week as well. Washington Huskies, they continue to lead the way in with even par on day one from Pasatiempo.
San Jose State University, located in a prime spot just 49 miles from San Francisco, 41 from Oakland, 85 from Napa Valley, 76 from Pebble Beach, and just 31 miles from Pasatiempo. Wonderful opportunities to play golf for this outstanding program.
Over at 11, Tom Guyant, the Oregon Duck, the sophomore, this for birdie at the par 4. Been on a little bit of a roll, 4-under his last 6, hit the hole, it did.
Ooh.
5-under through 7. Good thing that hole got in the way.
That had potential to run off the cliff there and down off the green in front. Very fortunate.
2-under on the day. What a spring for the man from France. A couple of tied for thirds at the Duck Invitational in the Goodwin, where he closed with 62 and then tied for 8th at the Wyoming Desert Intercollegiate. So head coach for the Ducks, Casey Martin, going to lean on this young man throughout the rest of the spring. Up at 17, Henry Fitzhugh from UC Irvine. That was for par, and just shows you how slow they are when you're underneath the hole, Kurt.
Yeah, I mean, they're just so much slope that they're ultra fast going down the slopes and relatively slow coming back up them.
Let's go back to 11. Another Oregon Duck, Yuki Moriyama, the freshman. Surprised we're seeing this many good looks at birdie here, Kurt. This 11th is a bear.
It's in that bowl, and if you hit a good iron shot, keep it in the bowl, you'll have a shot at it.
Yen for par at 17.
You know, set up by a poor tee shot. Just shows you have to be in control off the tee, and we said it at the top, but you got to put in the fairway to give yourself a chance to get it in somewhat of a reasonable, makeable putt.
So after going bogey-free for the first 14 holes, drop shots at 15 and 17 for Justin Yen. He falls out of that top spot. currently held by Finnegan Tilley from Cal, leading the way, a one-shot advantage. Currently 15 players under par. See William Mao there from Pepperdine, the standout sophomore, even par 70. Derek Kitchener, his teammate, but playing as an individual, not counting part of that team total. Pepperdine, one of the deepest teams in the country. Great chance to shore up their lineup. Michael Thorbjornsson from Stanford, 1 over 71 for the freshman. We're back with more from Santa Cruz right after this.
We are back at the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Titleist. We talked about the rich tradition of the San Jose State men's golf program. Well, the women's golf program, three-time national champions. Patty Hearst, the 1989 NCAA individual champion, currently ranked 57th in golf stat. Julie Inkster, 17 wins and a three-time All-American, grew up just off the 14th fairway here at Paso Tiempo Golf Club, worked at the golf club, even spent some time at Hattie's Snack Shack just off the 10th. So many great players have passed through Paso Tiempo. And speaking of the 14th, look back from behind the green. Back to the fairway.
What's your actual?
130.
Yeah, 22 probably, just because of the rough and the knuckle.
Cal's Finnegan Tilley will be first to play.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Finn, can you come back here for me so you can get it? Can
you get
down there?
The right one?
The left one.
Okay.
Yeah.
His assistant coach there, Chris Mazzalotti, helping him out.
Even if it's left without that, Reed will take it back right.
A huge swale that works its way across that fairway. And, it's easy to be down in there. Blind shot. Cool. This is going to turn out really well. What a great shot this is. He's going to have a really good look for birdie from there.
It was a great job, too, by the assistant coach to ask him to step back to take one more look at where your aiming point was. Alan Bruce for birdie at the 10th.
An uphill a little bit, so he was able to give that a pretty good wrap.
All things considered, where he was off the tee, he'll gladly take his par there at the 10th. Alan Bruce, the 2019 NJCAA individual champion, 10 individual wins during his Midland College career. So a par at the 10th for Bruce. Scoring average this year of 71.56 for Bruce. Carson Lindell, his second into 14.
Not a great angle from over there, but what a shot. Able to go in there with a wedge certainly helped. Throw it up against the breeze a little bit. It did land on the downslope, but kept it under control.
There you get a look at the BYU Cougars. Saw the play of Carson Lindell, a junior. Just one senior on the squad this year, Kelton Hirsch. And Bruce Brockback is the head coach, with Todd Miller, the assistant coach. Johnny Miller, sound familiar?
Little combo there, right? Johnny's son, Todd. How about that shot at the Open a couple years ago?
Johnny's out here getting an opportunity to watch his son and the BYU team compete. Longtime member of the NBC broadcast crew, and Johnny Miller, a winner of the Western Intercollegiate in 1968, winning the individual title. All right, to the tee at 18. A little rocky for Justin Yen of Hawaii, coming in with bogeys at 15 and 17.
And this is, and we've seen it already, a dangerous hole location on the left-hand side. It's This green at 18 is framed up beautifully with the bunkers behind and out to the right, and it does play slightly back down the hill. And what wind there is in from the right. And if you get it about 15 feet right of the hole high, it will definitely come back down toward the center of the green. There is a huge ridge on that right-hand side. We've already seen by now, if you miss it left here, certainly just to make bogeys a difficult. I'd expect this one out to the right. The call shot here is to bring it in high from right to left, and you better have your number dialed in here. You're in 68 yards. Just, as I said, just a light breeze from the right and in. Choked well down on this club here, looking out to the right.
Yeah, he's definitely set up out to the right.
Take a look at the Top Tracer technology, powered by Top Golf.
He's overcooked it to the left-hand side, needs a good kick off that ridge, and he's going to get it.
He reacted like it didn't have a chance to get back there.
Well, it started left and actually straightened up a little bit at the end. Originally, he just kind of put his head down. Okay, I've missed it left.
Next play, his teammate Justin Arcano. Justin making his third start at the Western Intercollegiate. Best finish was 2 years ago, a tie for 67th. So after a couple of bogeys over the last three holes, Justin Yen has an opportunity to finish with a birdie. 3 under leading the way here at the Western Intercollegiate. BYU's Carson Lindell for birdie at 14. Expecting it to break a little bit more than it did. So he remains at 1 under, 2 off the lead.
Moment ago at 11, San Diego State's Yosef Gazelle. We've seen a handful of birdies here over the past few groups. Kurt?
This one, it's obvious that he did not read it correctly, but this is what can happen at Pasatiempo. You get above the hole, you have to deal with those ridges. There's a false front here at 11. This ball is going to end up catching the false front and end up maybe 20 yards off the green now.
So a poor read that in normal circumstances he'd have a 5 or 6 footer remaining.
Yeah.
Now he's got a 25-yard pitch.
You get a little bit out of position here. You make a little bit of a mistake like he just did, and it just, you get punished by these greens.
So after that putt, this was the chip, his fourth.
Just not going to get far enough back to take advantage of the slope behind that hole. So.
Going to give at least one back.
Yeah.
Finnegan Tilley has a birdie putt at 14 for Cal. Chance to get the 4 under, but it on the low side, so he'll have this left for his par. He'll remain at 3 under and 1 shot in front. Well, it's time to tee off. Search, compare, save on your next round with no booking fees. Every course, every tee time, three fairways are waiting at teeoff.com or the Tee Off app. Take you over to 15.
Short par 3, 122 yards. Finnegan Tilley getting ready to go. Billy Ray's caught up with this group.
Well, thank you, Berko. And it's a really, really interesting hole here. 122 yards playing downhill. It looks very gettable, but that hole location just on that front left portion, so easy to go long here. They're taking dead aim. Just carries on the front, adds a very good shot there.
Just a wedge. Hit a good one, you'll have a great chance at birdie. And again, Tilly will have that upcoming at 15. Take a look at some past California State Fair champions, some notable winners. Finnegan Tilly taking home the honor a year ago. Brandon Hagee, another Cal standout in 2012. Kevin Sutherland, George Archer, and Ken Venturi back in 1950. Impressive list to be a part of. Song's tee shot on the way.
And a junior trying to bring this hit ball in from right to left, flatted it down. This looks good. It should turn just a little bit left once it takes a spin here.
Good one there by James Song. He too will have a great look at birdie. Cal's making a little run up this board, currently in second. Let's go back to the trials and tribulations of Yosef Gazel at 11. This for double bogey.
I mean, his second shot was 2 yards too far up to that top level.
At a 20 for birdie, made six. Carson Lundell at 15.
Yeah, also trying to bring that in from the right. Here's the spin.
Kurt, we were out there yesterday, and we thought that hole location would reward shots like that.
Yeah,
it's there.
It was going to be the one that they could get to at 15. The two tomorrow and Wednesday are going to be way different. Short hole still, but the hole locations are going to be way more difficult the next couple days.
That's Todd Miller, the BYU assistant coach, giving some words of advice to Keanu Akina from BYU. Three good ones up there. See if he can make it four.
Yeah, he's over on the right hand side of the tee box. This freshman trying to bring this ball in from the right as well. Might not have as much spin. Caught it just a bit thin. Just catches that front part of the green, and the penalty area is just a few paces short of where his ball carried.
Drop back to 10.
Second on the team in scoring average this season, Shane French of USC has a birdie putt to get to red figures at 10.
Boy, take advantage of those holes out there that are going to give up the occasional birdie, because there's a bunch of other tough ones.
Yuki Moriyama of Oregon has a birdie putt at the 12th for a share of the lead, and he pours that in.
That's one of the holes today because of that front hole location at 12 that they can get to and have a good look at birdie.
So Finnegan Tilly of Cal at 3-under, Yuki Moriyama of Oregon at 3-under. They have a one-shot lead. On March the 19th, we unexpectedly lost a beloved friend and colleague, Peter Patagno. Neil's love of sports and passion for television shown through all of his work. He was a driving creative force behind the promotional look of our college golf coverage that you see on air today. Neil is survived by his wife, Carolyn, and daughter, Noelle. He'll be dearly missed, and all of us here at Golf Channel send our condolences.
Back to the green at the par 3 15th. Birdie putt upcoming for California's Finnegan Tilly.
Yeah, good look after a fine tee shot here. Said that par 3 only 122 yards, so hole location that you can get. A freshman from BYU, Akina, did make par. Two putts that he had here at the par 3. This putt actually slightly back uphill and give this one a pretty good little hit.
Not enough, so Tilly will remain 3-under.
After a wonderful tee shot into 18, Justin Yen for birdie. So after bogeys at 15 and 17, Yen finishes with a birdie at 18, posting a 3-under 67. Has him in a share of the lead.
Back to the green at 15, James Song for birdie.
Yeah, just kept the speed up enough to hold the line. Very nicely done.
Moves James Song to 1-under. A couple shots off the lead. Again, Cal making a bit of a run. Solo second right now. A few shots behind Washington. Keep it here with Carson Lundell from BYU.
I like the fashion statement here with the longer socks. I like that look.
Brings you back to the days at Houston.
That's exactly right. tennis player Jimmy Connors always wore the long socks as well. This ball will turn left if you do not keep the pace up. It'll cut right across the hole to the left. All right. Well played.
Birdie's on two of his last three. He's now two under. Lundell a shot off the lead. One of the leaders for the BYU Cougars. Take a look at the breakthrough win. Nick Watney Invitational a little bit earlier this year. Tied at the top, 13 under. Both co-medalists, but both pick up an individual collegiate victory. So hats off to Carson for that win. Quick walk over to 16, Bob, and ready golf in college golf.
Well, no doubt about that, and this is one of the cool components, Kurt, of these older style golf courses where the greens and tees are close together.
Yeah, it's awesome, and it makes it very walkable. You can see from that shot from behind the players, they kind of want to go up and over that hillside, more so on the left if they can. It doglegs pretty hard down that hill to the left. So kind of where that swale is, just left of the highest part up at the top of that hill. And that's a perfect line.
Well, Kurt, the popular choice of clubs off the tee has been the long irons. Tee shot comes back up the hill. Once it gets over that hill in which you speak of, players lose sight of it. Blind tee shot here.
That should
chase out.
Yeah, that's fine. Almost dead center of the fairway. Do not go in that divot.
James Song, Jr., next to play.
He is well going with the long iron off the tee. Got it just a bit heavy.
A little left, too. Let's see. Down that left side of the fairway, it's going to end up just fine.
Kurt, with that hole location, it gives him a good angle coming
it
in.
It does. A little bit better angle than in the center or right side of this fairway.
Keanu Acuna, next to play.
And it's hanging out to the right just a bit here.
Well, it did stay in the fairway, which is huge as far as this next shot goes. I've seen a few shots from that light rough. It's not long rough, but it's just you lose control of the back of the ball.
Now Lundell with a low bullet there coming off that birdie at 15.
No problems there.
The RBC Heritage presented by Boeing, which was played in June last year, back in April once again. Defending champion Webb Simpson heading to Hilton Head. Coverage begins Thursday at 3 p.m. Eastern on golf. It's the 74th playing of the Western Intercollegiate. 3-under leads the way in the individual competition. Team competition, Washington in at even. We are back at the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Topgolf. In the 74th year of the Western Intercollegiate, hosted by San Jose State, we want to thank Positiempo Golf Club. Scott Hoyt is the general manager. Played on the San Jose State men's golf team in 1975 and 76, was a 1976 honorable mention All-American. Marie Tewitt, the director of athletics, San Jose State, and Justin Mandan and his staff, a wonderful job here on the golf course at Positiempo. Thanks to all for making our visit here special. Keen is second in the second team.
Yeah, it was from 153 yards.
Wow. That's a big miss short left. He does have kind of the angle. If you're going to have a pitch shot, he has to pitch over the bunker. That shouldn't be a problem. And a backstop behind it.
34. I mean, at least in 10.
136.
Yeah.
I'm going to go.
Carson Lindell now playing his second into 16.
Yeah, he's found the fairway, but just not a great angle from that right-hand side. He's going to be forced to go out to the left. He's got 140 yards to the flag. 133 will carry that ridge, but if you carry the ridge, you got to have a no spin.
Go, go.
I think that's there.
Go in.
Oh, no. No. What a terrible break.
That is so unlucky.
And at least he has some room behind the ball, but he hit a very good shot in there. These are big, solid wooden pins here as well, flag sticks, and they are, that is just a tough one to swallow right there.
Next up, Cal's Finnegan Tilly.
Now this is where you check a player out, being able to flight the ball like he needs to.
If you're comfortable with at it, knowing the wind's going to move a little bit, I'm good with that too.
Okay.
130 is the number.
Be a little careful with the spin here. If you really hit this crispy with a lot of spin, there's slope that'll run it right back off the green.
Just coming off the downhill ever so slightly, this out to the left. It's got to be easy here.
No, that's coming off the green.
Yep.
A tough, tough hole location. There really aren't any easy hole locations on this green at 16.
It's exactly what you just showed earlier today, exactly what happened right there.
Finnegan Tilly of Cal, a senior, and you take a look at what he did at the 2019 Tavistock Collegiate Invitational with a stack field, finished third, shooting 7 under. Well, Billy Ray, James Song of Cal, the best angle in here to 16.
Yeah, it's down there just 99 yards for Song. And I like this angle coming from the left-hand side. He can actually take this ball out to the right a bit. That's going to have a lot of spin, too.
Here's the slope. Not going to
stop.
There's
that spin right there.
Kurt, when we were out there earlier today, you got to be right at the flag with not a lot of spin.
Right. You have to be right at the flag, but then that brings in the bunker. You know, you miss it a little more right. Now you're down in there in that bunker. It's just such a tough spot. I'm not sure I've seen a slopier green than this 16th.
Back at the par 5, 13th, Carl Corpus from San Jose State raced his birdie putt by, so this to keep him at 1 under. A couple of shots off the lead. He'll take it. Go up to 15, the lefty, Jake Solin from Oregon.
Got the club twirl. Got to be pretty good, and it is.
It's getting better and better. So Jake's going to have that for birdie in just a moment. Another Oregon Duck, Jake's teammate, Moriyama, his third at the par 5.
Just had some trouble off the tee. He is well back there for his third shot.
Got the overhanging limbs on the left there, and if you try to fly it all the way back there, the bunker right.
Yeah.
Washington's been done for a while. Their score has held up even par for the Huskies on day one. Cal making a big move. Pepperdine 4 off the lead as day one action from the Western Intercollegiate continues.
This just a moment ago, the third shot for Carson Lindell of BYU at 16.
Multiple options here. What type of shot he wants to play. Plays a low spinner up there.
Darn good. Right to the crest of that ridge. Still plenty of slope. How about this shot? A lot of confidence in that pitching ability.
Finnegan Tilley, his third shot.
He's taking a totally different route here. Interesting. I didn't see that play.
Making it look easy.
Take a look at the California Golden Bears with Athletic Director Jim Knowlton, Walter Chun, the head coach. And you see this squad with Finnegan Tilley as the lone senior. A lot of talent. You saw Colin Morikawa playing in this event just 2 years ago, the last time we were here. Song's third.
After those two fine shots from Tilley and Lundell, trying to use a slope here, Kurt.
Yeah. Now it needs to slow down just a little bit.
Easy.
Very nice. All three really well played. That's kind of the safety shot, using that slope behind the hole. Got to stay right at that hole location to do it, though.
Up to 17. Samson Zhang from Cal, freshman, his second of the par four.
Dude, yeah, I just think my way around golf courses.
Oh, go in.
Ooh.
Pretty good there. Look at his notable amateur finishes before he went to Cal and sort of had a run on the AJGA, winning the Daniel Berger Junior Championship in 2018, year prior, the AJGA Junior at the Seagate. And that leads to a Rolex Junior All-America selection, one of the best a few years ago in junior golf.
Over at 16, Keanu Aquino for his par.
Now, we saw his second shot come up short left of the bunker, and he played a nice shot in there as well to keep it on that proper level. Now, but then has a little movement from left to right to save his par here.
Oregon's Yuki Moriyama, his fourth shot here at the par 5 13th. Not much green here, Kurt.
No, it's pretty flat when it lands on the green, though. So he had a good chance from there. He's lucky he got a good rake job in there. Someone did a nice job.
Par putt for Song. This is on the high side.
And that just shows the difficulty. He had a shot of 99 yards left for a second. And difficulty making par there just shows the severity of this green.
Back at 13, Chris Stiles from San Jose State. This for birdie for the host school. This to get to two under. Think he thought he had it. Ready golf over at 17, looking from high above. Finnegan Tilley, you going to fire one here, Billy Ray?
Going with driver. The wind has died down just a bit, but it's still just slightly back in the wind here at 17. Comes back up the hill. Those bunkers down the right don't present any problem whatsoever. But if you challenge that left-hand side, that's where you'd like to be, given that hole location on the left-hand side. But just across the cart path is out of bounds.
Straight away, if you can get it past the cart path that crosses the fairway, it's about 300.
Oh, this is a beauty, Kurt.
Sure is.
Low piercing draw. Should stay in the fairway.
Yeah, that sets him up for that next shot. In the fairway, he'll be able to spin a sand wedge in there.
Keep it right here with Lundell, less than driver.
Yeah, he's got 3 wood out here. Just stings it. I mean, this ball, oh my goodness, that ball didn't get probably 10 feet off the ground, and that was stung up the left-hand side. That's definitely going to chase out.
Yeah, the road is 267 yards out on the left-hand side, and that sort of angles slightly about 284 on the right-hand side, and it's a pretty darn good three-wood off the tee there.
That was really fun to watch there. That was absolutely nailed.
Now James Song.
Also going with lesson driver here. And right off the deck here. Another low billet. This up the left-hand side, though.
That out of bounds creeps in quickly.
Oh, man. Get a kick. There you go.
My goodness.
That was close. Well, how lucky was that?
That was taking a dead aim out of bounds in those bushes. I think he knows. Maybe he knows. He got away with it. Right there, you think it hit the edge of the curve of the road, hits that bush, kicks down right.
Now he's really, with that angle, even from the rough, he's got an opportunity.
Definitely a good break there.
How about Sean Yu from San Jose State? This for birdie at 13 2 years ago. Lost in a five-hole playoff to Stanford's Isaiah Salinda. Not having the best of days, battling some injuries for the senior.
Over at 18, redshirt freshman Kostas Pinay of Cal on the tee.
That's not at all what I was trying to do, Coach, I promise.
That will work.
He apologized to Coach.
I think he started it way left to the green and hit a big cut in there.
You don't apologize for results like that, do you? Oh, my goodness. Yuki Moriyama, this for par 13. Nice save from the greenside bunker for the Oregon freshman. He remains 3-under. He's sharing the top spot. A couple other players.
How do you think he feels the day after the Masters? He's from Japan.
A global victory for Hideki Matsuyama at Augusta National yesterday. Certainly a resounding effect around the world of golf as we continue to bring you first round action for the 74th Western Intercollegiate.
After 1 year at Long Beach State, playing in his first year with Oregon, Owen Averett, birdie at 14.
Wow.
Yeah. From way downtown, that was about 50 feet.
So after back-to-back bogeys, a long birdie at 14. See, Oregon right now is a team in a tie for fifth with Stanford, who's done. Over to 17.
Second shot upcoming for California's James Song after a wonderful break, Billy Ray.
He does not know what unfolded up there. You couldn't see the tee shot at all as it came back up the hill, but all is good now, just 126 yards.
Yeah, I think you want to hit 20. I think these are land at like 19 or 20, and then it'll bounce. So, yeah, I like that. Yeah, right at the TV tower.
Yeah, if you can judge it, coming out of this lie here, shouldn't have much spin on it. I love the angle coming from the left-hand side. He's laying this ball probably some 25 feet short and out to the left and let the slope take it.
Not bad.
Up at 18, Kostas Pinay for his birdie to finish even for the day.
Playing a ton of break. Just trying to ease it down there, and it still wasn't enough. I mean, he was 7 feet from the hole, maybe, and playing 3 feet of break.
A little Ray Romano look going, too, for Kostas Pinay.
Back at 17, Tilly set to go. Cal's just two back.
Yeah, left in a great position. Ball's just below his feet here. The wind has kicked out back into the player's face here. got 104 yards total. I'm trying to flight it down and bring it in from the left. Solid strike.
The little nuances, Kurt, of where to try to get your approach shot to end up.
Just a good
one. Now, Lundell.
Got to be precise.
Yeah, wonderful tee shot Lundell played down this fairway. Just 101 yards. Yeah, really quick swing there, trying to bring him from the left as well.
A little closer to the green, able to spin it a little harder.
Best of the bunch out of those four guys.
San Jose State freshman Carl Corpus for birdie at 14. Oh. That was to move to within one of the lead. Kurt, one of the really cool things that the PGA Tour has come up with is PGA Tour University for NCAA Division I players who complete a minimum of 4 years of college. And at the conclusion of the spring season, the top 15 players earn exempt status. Eligibility for the top 15 players begins a week after the NCAA Division I National Championships, giving guys a place to play that have excelled at the collegiate ranks for years.
Being able to go right out and start playing the Corn Ferry Tour for those top five guys is tremendous. The other players on that list, they get some
PGA Tour, Latino America, Canada, PGA Tour China when they're fully playing due to the pandemic. It's the opportunity, Kurt. Everyone says when you leave school, where can you go play?
Yeah.
To watch these top five and top 15 over the next 6 weeks?
That's right.
Going to be a lot of interested spectators, not only on that list, but family members and us as well, seeing exactly where they end up, because Garrett Reband made a big jump a couple weeks ago to get in that top five.
That top five is so huge because they could go right to the Corn Ferry Tour, catch fire, and end up with a PGA Tour card at the end of 2021.
Oregon sophomore Tom Guyon playing his second into 14.
And in that rough, this should come out with no spin. Let's see, just a wedge, so. Yeah. The difference between being just in the fairway there or the rough.
Oregon Ducks, led by head coach Casey Martin in his fifth winner in 2018. And what a scene it was at Eugene Country Club back in 2016.
Aaron Wise right there.
AA championship on their home course. John Rahm, Scotty Scheffler, Bo Hostler, all part of that Texas squad. It was incredible drama at Eugene Country Club.
Still get goosebumps seeing that, Bob. One of the great scenes we've ever been a part of.
Yuki Moriyama, second into 14.
Big drive down there. Just a sand wedge second shot.
I can use a little. Okay.
Ahead to the par 4 17th.
Finnegan Tilly's got this. Look at birdie.
Yeah, it is a look, but it's going to have to be very, very gingerly coming down this slope. This is really fast, going to turn hard to his left. Just got to get this one started. Yeah, that's what happens, Kurt. You get on the wrong side, you have to putt defensively.
Not a great wedge shot for him in there.
Back at 13, the par 5, San Diego State's Yosef Gazelle, his third shot.
Got an angle here, Burko. Let's see what he can do with it.
Go in.
Oh no.
We saw the mishap at 11. I thought maybe a little bit of redemption there for Gazelle at 13.
A great shot, no matter what.
Back at 17, James Song, this for birdie.
you know, first putt, you'll see that he can get aggressive with the first half, slightly back up the hill. Then once it starts turning right, it will pick up some speed, but very makeable from here. Whoa.
Hammered that.
Wow. That's a good 10, maybe 12 feet past the hole now.
Got the break off the tee. Now struggling to make four. Carson Lundell from BYU next to go.
Watching that putt from Song, you got to think right now that Carson Lundell, that might be a little gun shy. He'll actually give us a lot of air out to the left if it goes in. I got to think on the last couple rolls here. And you can play on this putt here. If you got the right speed, you can get it out there maybe 2.5, maybe 3 feet out to the left. Oh, you bet.
Great read, great speed. Three birdies in his last five holes. Carson Lundell now 3 under, sharing that top spot with three others.
Morgan's Tom Guyant with a long birdie putt at 14.
From the back of the green. It's uphill, actually, putting from the back part of the green. Pretty darn good speed.
Back over to 17.
See if James Song can save his par.
And just didn't take advantage of that great break off the tee.
363-yard par 4. Back-to-back bogeys now for Song. He's one over.
San Jose State's Sean Yu has a lengthy birdie putt over at 14. Runner-up in the individual last year, losing in a five-hole playoff to Isaiah Celinda.
Knows exactly what this putt does. Let's see if he can get it even closer. Yep.
Putt is good for you.
Yeah. Finnegan Tilly, a little work left at 17 for his par. Keep Cal a couple back. Keep Tilly tied at the top, 3 under. At 15, Carl Corpus from San Jose State. Short par 3. This to get to 200. These guys are taking advantage of relatively benign conditions out here.
They are. I mean, there's not much wind. I mean, it's not chilly, really. I mean, it's chilly, but it could be a lot worse than this. So if you're going to get it, this is a good day to do it.
Kelton Hirsch of BYU has a birdie putt at 18. Pours it in, drips it in, a 1-under 69 for the senior, and just 2 off the lead.
Callum Bruce going to give it a go here at the par 5 13th, his second.
Middle of the green would be a good result. You try to go into that back left where the hole is, and it's tough to get it there. That's the problem right there. He hit a really nice shot, but it hits on that downslope. Going to kick through the green.
Oregon's Yuki Moriyama with a birdie putt at 14 to get to 4 under and grab the outright lead. Yep, these greens will just make you laugh sometimes.
Poana in itself is tough to putt on, you know, and then you throw this kind of slope into these greens and undulation, it becomes a real challenge.
Back there, it was, you know, about 4 or 5 yards. There's not a whole lot right now.
Waiting for the green to clear at 18.
169 flat. It's
Just right at that tree, or right where the station tower is.
Yeah, just a little draw.
Yep.
Looks like Carson Lindell will be first to go.
Well, 168 yards now, just trying to actually gauge the wind here. He's going to start this ball right, almost right at our crane, just right of the flag, about 20 feet, and try to hit this draw. Using no tee at all, just right off the deck here.
We'll take a look at Top Tracer technology, powered by Topgolf, to follow the tee shot of Carson Lindell at 18.
Trying to turn it over a bit. It's hanging out to the right. Now we'll funnel back down that slope. Hit it right where he was looking at, just unable to turn it. See, I shot a number of times throughout the day.
It'll be a challenging two-putt from down there.
But, Kurt, if you're going to miss, that's one of the better spots to miss it at.
Yeah, I mean, anything that doesn't get to that top shelf over there is going to end up there. They are all going to funnel back down to that spot.
Keanu Akina next to play.
You know, you see these players and you think about, okay, this hole's not that long, 168 yards. Majority of the time they're taking dead aim, but the severity of these greens, players actually have to play defensively with this shot. This is right on line, though.
Oh, yeah, very nice. That'll stay there. A little flat spot right there. Really good shot.
He was back here watching, making sure it would stay there on that little ridge, Kurt.
Kurt, the interesting part, though, is you watch it at home and you say, wow, it's a really great shot. He's not that far from the hole until you get to the green, and then you actually have to putt it.
Yeah.
And what's going to happen is movement.
Yeah, he'll have some movement to the left there. Not as much as the one we saw just a moment ago, but it definitely has some left turn in it.
Now Finnegan Tilley primarily likes to work the ball from right to left. He's looking out there pretty far to the right now. He's going to try to hit this big draw in here from right to left. And turning it over. This is a good looking shot, Kurt. This is right at it.
A huge draw. Very nice.
So Finnegan Tilley is going to have that putt to get to four under and grab the lead.
And watching Finnegan Tilley these last few holes, and what a golf swing he has, Kurt. It's in rhythm. He doesn't try to overpower the golf ball. He still has power, but he swings within himself and nice pace in the swing.
James Song, last to play.
Yeah, he's definitely going to work this ball in from right to left. He's going over the extreme right-hand side of the tee box. And that breeze has switched a little bit. Now it's in and from the right, helping turn the shot over. Another good-looking line here. I mean, this is just barely right of the flag. Is it enough?
Man, it's going to be about 5 yards short of where it needed to be.
Look good from the tee box when he hit it right on the button. Just a small little window.
Maybe not even 5 yards, maybe even just a couple yards short of where it needed to be to stay on that top shelf.
Drop back to 15, the short par three, Oregon's Yuki Moriyama, co-leader at 3 under. Trying to get a little better.
That'll be a little quick.
You think? Might move a little bit too?
Yep.
So Moriyama's got that for birdie upcoming at 15. Four-way tie at the top. 3 under leading the way. Justin Yen from Hawaii in with that 67. William Mao, even par 70 for Pepperdine. And how about Puit Anupan Subsai from San Diego State, even through 12. Husky still leading the way in the team side of things. Even par, 3 clear, Cal.
We're back at the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Titleist from Paso Tiempo in Santa Cruz, California. Take a look at Western Intercollegiate alums to win on the PGA Tour just this season alone. Bryson DeChambeau winning the U.S. Open and the Arnold Palmer Invitational. Patrick Cantlay, Patrick Reed, Max Homa, Colin Morikawa, and Jordan Spieth. All winners just this year alone on the PGA Tour that have had an opportunity to compete here at Paso Tiempo in the Western Intercollegiate. James Song second at 18.
Very nice. Severely uphill, coming out of the rough.
Callum Bruce at 13, greenside bunker. How about that touch?
Should be able to handle that putt, make a nice birdie.
Now at 15, we saw Yuki Moriyama's tee shot to this point at the par three. This for the outright lead. Didn't move as much as I thought originally. Yuki, the first Japanese golfer to compete in three straight U.S. Junior Amateur Championships, did that from 2017 to 2019. Heck of a run there, and a heck of a run for Japan golf at Augusta National. Kajitani winning the Augusta National Women's Amateur about 10 days ago, and then Hideki Matsuyama winning the Masters yesterday.
Lindell for his birdie and the outright lead at 18.
That's got to get going. Run up and mark that quick before it decides to turn around and go the other way.
Second shot for Carl Korpus of San Jose State at 16. He's just a shot off the lead.
Oh my God.
Not even close to the right club.
Take a look at San Jose State, the host of the Western Intercollegiate, with athletic director Marie Tewitt, John Kennedy. Always serving as gracious host. Had the chance to catch up with John earlier today in his 16th season as head coach. Won the 1948 NCAA championship. Now Lindell for his par at 18. So that drops him out of a share of the lead. 2 under par, 68.
Green at 15. Tom Guyant from Oregon. This for birdie.
Yeah, left in a perfect position here. We've seen some putts made from this section of the green today here.
Almost saw another.
Over at 18. Finnegan Tilley has a birdie putt for Cal and a chance to post 4 under and have the outright lead.
Made 3 bogeys today, but he really kind of got going there at the 9th hole. Hit a good second shot in there and made eagle at 9. A couple of bogeys at 12 and 13. Excuse me, birdies at 12 and 13. And oh, I thought for sure he would make that.
Missed opportunity over to 13.
First look at USC's Tyler Guo for birdie at the par 5. I would have got him into the log jam at the top, 3 under.
All right, over to 16. Let's see what Carl Korpus does here with his third.
See if he goes past, uses the slope. Looks like he's going to try. Let's hope it doesn't have too much momentum going this direction now. Slow down. Yeah. Very nice.
Tilley for his par at 18. Missed opportunity for Finnegan Tilley, but a beautiful round today. 3 under. 67. has him in a share of the lead. Trying to join names like Ken Venturi, Johnny Miller, Peter Jacobson, Bobby Clampett, Mark O'Meara, Maverick McNeely, Scotty Fleshman, Scheffler, Patrick Rogers as individual winners of the Western Intercollegiate.
Did you mention Aaron Oberholzer?
Our own Aaron Oberholzer.
Come on, man. Golf Channel's Aaron Oberholzer won here.
That's right. Well, we heard about it so much last year.
He may have mentioned that this is his favorite golf course as well.
I think. Give it a little breather. We'll get AO a couple more pops in Santa Cruz. Notable individual champions of the Western Intercollegiate. Roman Zhang won in 2018. Justin Suh, 2017. See our own Aaron Oberholzer. San Jose State, 1996. The last player from San Jose State to win the individual title. Bobby Clampett, Mark O'Meara, Peter Jacobson, Johnny Miller, whose son is assistant coach at BYU, and, of course, Ken Venturi. Two-time champion. Moriyama on the tee at 16.
Well, we've seen this a number of times today. Just going with iron off the tee, just trying to find the fairway.
No problem there. Didn't sound quite solid. He's pretty far back up the hill.
Back one at 15, tee shot on the way for USC's Kyle Supa. One of the few to miss the green here at the short par three.
San Jose State's Carl Corpus to finish up his par at 16 and remain one back.
A nice up and down. Got creative. Used that backstop to bring the ball back to the hole.
Back at 15. Cameron Henry next to go. Another USC Trojan. Had to look good. It was. He sort of burst on the scene a couple of years ago here at the Western Intercollegiate back in 2019. Cameron Henry in his college debut finished tied for fifth. Look at the guy stroke behind him in seventh. Colin Morikawa, now a major champ. Justin Suh was top-ranked amateur of the world at one point as well.
You know, we gave that list of notable winners. You know, when you think about the notable participants, we showed you, you know, Bryson DeChambeau having won twice on the PGA Tour in the last year. Tiger Woods, Jordan Spieth, Tom Watson, John Rahm, Colin Morikawa. Players that competed here and did not win the individual. Let's take you over to 16 and Yuki Moriyama of Oregon getting set to play a second shot into the difficult green at 16.
And this is one of the longest shots that I've seen. That tee shot didn't roll very much at all. He's got 146 yards. 141 carries that slope coming off the downslope. Maybe with a little bit more distance curve to take some of the spin off and keep it on that level, and I think that's going to be the case there.
Settle down. I don't know. When you get left over there, there's even a little bit more slope. Hang in there. Just does.
Look
at him. He's like, oh, please stop.
Can he sprint up there to put a mark on it?
I mean, that's literally a foot, maybe 18 inches from going all the way off the front and having to hit a pitch shot for his third.
Tom Guyon, his teammate, playing his second.
Yeah, that's something to take note of coming here at 16. He was, and to check the yards, he was a little bit further than what I anticipated. But coming in there with a club, that a little bit more club and less spin to try to keep it up on that level. This one coming in very high into the left.
Wow, and just about exactly right.
Oh my
well
goodness.
Done.
Best I've seen so far here, Kurt.
Yeah, that was a really good approach shot.
worthy of a fist bump. Up 1-17. Carl Corpus from San Jose State. His tee shot. Looks like it's heading down the right-hand side. Popular spot down there, Kurt.
Yeah, that might not have been hit real well. It seemed like it fell out of the sky a little bit.
Fairway slopes from left to right on that 363-yard par 4. Picture-perfect Monday at Paso Tiempo. Glad to be back in Santa Cruz, California for the 74th playing of the Western Intercollegiate. Washington still at the top. Cal Pepperdine rounding out the top three. We're back for more right after this.
It was really special just because my dad's there. He's my swing coach. I had a putting coach there as well. And, you know, now that I'm out here on tour, it's really cool to have a bunch of fans back home. And everyone, the San Diego State alum is very strong with the Aztecs. So it is cool. You know, wherever I kind of go, I'll get an Aztecs holler here and there. So that's pretty nice.
Xander Schauffele, a standout for San Diego State, was in that final pairing. The Masters had a chance to win yesterday as we take a look at Puit Anupan Subsai, maybe the next standout for the Aztecs. He rolls that in for birdie at 13, gets him to 1 under par. As we take a look at San Diego State's season in review, presented by Titleist, and what a spring it has been for the Aztecs, winning that opener in January, the Southwestern Invitational. Then they come into this one off another victory at the Wyoming Cowboy Classic. Keep an eye on the Aztecs heading into the postseason. Maybe one of those squads that could make a run at the NCAA Championships. Certainly a talented group included in the mix. This young man, Callum Bruce, the senior, second at 14.
Short right, challenging bunker shot.
Speaking of San Diego State, we'll keep the Aztec theme going. Josep Gazelle, the junior, for birdie at 15.
And they won that Southwestern. They really performed in some extreme conditions, windy and cold. As a team, they really played some great golf.
Overtaking Arizona State that final round.
Over at 16. Yuki Moriyama of Oregon, the freshman, has birdie putt.
Yeah, coming across the green left to right here. Out of the four shots here, the first time I've seen three players up on the proper level have decent birdie looks here at 16.
Boy, he misread the speed on that one pretty badly. Wow.
Up at 17, second shot upcoming for Carl Corpus, freshman from San Jose State. Just can't mess with that hole location on the right-hand side.
Not when you drive it in the right rough, that's for sure.
San Jose State's Christopher Stiles, freshman, for his birdie.
Kurt, first one I've seen from the right of the hole for birdie coming down the hill there.
A couple of missed opportunities. He had a short putt at 13. Another one here at 16.
And also had a pretty good look at 15 as well.
Could have been a lot better here with a couple of made putts.
Well, speaking of San Jose State, take a look at the history of the Western Intercollegiate. 12 victories, their last coming in 1994. Stanford won the last edition in 2019. So they're one back. Fresno State is two. USC and BYU in the field this week with 7 each. Oregon with 5. Now Moriyama for his par.
Yeah, a lot of work left here. Learned a lot from the putt from San Jose State Styles here.
Thank you.
That's one of those that will drive his coaches crazy, though. He's got it in there. He's hit a good second shot. Tough hole location. Decent look from, you know, just outside 20 feet. Makes that mistake with the speed.
And that'll drop him out of a share of the lead.
So many times, Kurt, today.
He falls one back with three under leading the way. USC's Tyler Guo, sophomore, with this putt for birdie. Wanders past a bit.
5-6 feet.
Wow, says Guo. Speed on the greens here at Pasatiempo. Make you have to be very careful. Finnegan Tilley, Justin Yen in at 3 under. They share the lead. Yuki Moriyama giving a shot back at 16. Take a look at the team competition. Washington played earlier in the day. Even par for the day. They've got a 3-shot lead over Cal and Pepperdine. They are finished with USC still on the golf course here at Pasatiempo. Ken Venturi of San Jose State won the Western Intercollegiate in 1951 and 1953. Johnny Miller for BYU in 1968. John Rahm competed here from 2013 to 2016. Tom Watson, also a competitor at the Western Intercollegiate. We're back at the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Topgolf. It's Alistair McKenzie Design, opened September the 8th, 1929. Take you over to 17.
Tee shot on the way for Stiles.
Yeah, all indications, picking up the tee quickly there. Just finds the right hand side of the rough. Not a great angle. We've seen so many tee shots with the out of bounds down the left hand side end up in that right hand rough.
Kellen Bruce has a par putt at 14.
Saw him get in there early and watch that previous putt. I think he got a little bit of a read there. Didn't break as much right as he may have originally thought. So, way to take advantage.
And he's just 2 off the lead.
Earlier at 17, Carl Corpus, freshman, San Jose State. See if he could roll this one in for birdie and get a share of that top spot. Short one remaining to remain 2 under. Now back to the tee with Yuki Moriyama.
Yeah, this hole playing a little bit longer right now. The sun's starting to set a bit here. Temperatures dropped probably 8 to 10 degrees in the last 10 or 15 minutes here. Tee shot back up the hill. Not much breeze at all now. He didn't leave anything cheated there. This is up the right-hand side. Big swing there.
That's way right. That was over in the trees.
Yeah, that's going to be tree trouble. That's for sure. That huge tree, that evergreen up the right-hand side, is going to present an issue.
Moment ago, Caleb Shetler of San Jose State on the tee at 18. Beauty there for Shetler. Now live, Carl Corpus. Take a look at Top Tracer technology powered by Topgolf.
Coach Kennedy there, helping his players finish off their round. This is hanging out to the right. Stay. It's not going to stay, and it'll probably end up close to 50 feet from the hole.
Earlier we talked about, and Kurt, you mentioned John Kennedy in his 16th year as the head coach of San Jose State. I had a chance to visit with him on the first tee earlier today, and so excited about getting this event back up and running. All Pac Coast first team in 1986 and 87.
Might be the same hat. One of the true great ones out there in college golf. We're thrilled to be back here for sure.
Tyler Guo has this left for par at 14 to remain one back. Put a mark on that. Well, Washington played earlier in the day, even par. Right now they've got three-shot lead over Cal, four over Pepperdine, USC five back with still holes to play here at the 74th playing of the Western Intercollegiate.
Back at 17, Oregon's Yuki Moriyama, his second.
We have 126 yards, got to flight this down. I expect this out to the left. Oh, this ball's flying. It's actually headed out to the right. Oh my goodness. What a break that is. That ball hits on that mound and kicks left.
He'll take it. If we go to 15, Tyler Guo set to go here at the par three. Three pretty good ones there, Kurt.
Pretty darn good. Again, take advantage today because the next two hole locations are a lot tougher.
Guillaume, second on the way.
Yeah, it's lofting that high from 110 yards. Ordinary there.
Make sure you join us for second round action from Santa Cruz, California as the Western Intercollegiate presented by Topgolf and Titleist continues tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern. In primetime collegiate golf, as we take it back over to 17.
Chris Stiles getting ready for his second out of the rough as well.
Yeah, a little guesswork out of this lie here. It's only got 107 yards. This ball kind of came out flat and dead here.
Going to work out.
It certainly is.
Green at 15, USC's Leon D'Souza. This for birdie. Yeah, keep an eye on USC. Slowly making their way up the leaderboard. Everyone's journey, a little bit different. Then the next, take a look at Leon D'Souza in 2018 and 2019, the NJCAA National Champion. Success can breed success, doesn't matter where you play, Kurt.
Yeah, at South Mountain Community College there in the Phoenix area, they have put together some great teams through the years, always sort of a powerhouse in the junior college, community college ranks.
Birdie putt for Steve Sugimoto on the way. Again, you'll see that a lot in college golf. They are sort of given that free rein. If you're ready, go. Especially out in foursomes. We don't see that a ton in the college golf world throughout the course of the season. Yeah, Callum Bruce, a couple of years at Division II. Midland College, two-time National Player of the Year in that category. So it's... You know, you hear about the transfer portal in recent years in football and basketball, but we're seeing it a lot in the past few years in college golf as well.
Think about the community college route. I mean, a lot of players, when they get out of high school, aren't quite ready for Division I golf. And sometimes, you know, if their goal is to play Division I golf, it's not the worst thing in the world to go to a community college and develop your game after a couple years and then find your way into Division I like he did at San Diego State.
Bruce to get the two under. Just burns the edge now. Tom Guyant, his birdie putt upcoming here at 17.
Yeah, a little short of the hole here. Really tough read. The first half of this putt, it's going to move back to the left off the slope to his right, then back right at the end.
It's amazing how many times when these college players make mistakes on the greens, a lot of times they just hit their putts too hard. How many putts have we seen
that
end up
six, seven
feet past the hole?
Zihao Chin from San Diego State has this putt for par. Oof.
Back at 17, Yuki Moriyama from Oregon. See if he can bounce back.
Kurt, you just spoke about hitting the initial putts when you're out of position too hard. Moriyama cannot afford to do this here. This is very, very fast, coming down the slope, turning back to the left. It's one of these putts here that you've just got to get started. Back give it some room out to the right.
Back at 16, he ran it good 7-8 feet past. See if he can get it right here.
That needs to put the full flaps on here when it turns left.
There it is right there. I mean,
yep.
That's
another six-footer coming
six
back.
6 feet. It's just crazy.
Yep.
Up at 18, Carl Korpus for his par.
Great position to putt from. Going uphill.
Good putt, Carl.
Aggressive stroke. Very nice.
Nicely done, and a 2-under par 68 leads him a shot off the lead.
His teammate, Chris Stiles, on the green at 17.
Yeah, very makeable from this position here. He saw the putt of Keon as it worked its way back uphill. How hard it turned right at the end. See if he's got it matched up with speed and line,
there
and does.
Go. Finally got one to go.
Man, that's fantastic there.
He doesn't mess around. That routine goes pretty quick.
Yep. Breath of fresh air there, watching someone just look at it and pull the trigger. I love it.
Yeah, we'll take that. We'll applaud quick golf.
Yeah, exactly.
Caleb Shetler of San Jose State misses the birdie putt, and he's got just as much left for par now.
That's the trouble. You know, you on Poana, when they're this fast, you try to power one in, and you're going to have the same thing coming back.
See if Sean Yu can follow his teammate Stiles with a birdie at 17.
Yeah, they got a good read from Moriyama. Oregon, as his butt came down the hill, almost in the exact line here. He's going to play it way out to the right here. Just let it funnel in.
About that,
oh,
ring.
Yeah. Two fantastic putts here at 17 there by you and also by Stiles from San Jose State.
Spartans trying to put a little late charge on here in the last couple of holes. We'll keep it right here. Work left for Guyon.
Seen a number of putts from this area missed and being a little tentative here as it comes back up the hill, it drastically turns back to the left.
Bogey for Guyon. He drops back to even par. One hole to go. We drop back to 15. Shane French ready to go. Freshman from USC.
Nice shot, Shane.
Thanks. They're scaring it. A handful of them. Giving it a great look. Take a look at the USC Trojans. JT Higgins in his first year as head coach after nearly two decades at Texas A&M and a relatively young team. Shane French, you can make the argument, maybe the most talented on this squad, just a freshman. They've won this tournament 7 times, last coming 4 years ago in 2017. Now see if Moriyama can make par at 17. A little bit of stress, but in with 4. Remains 1 back.
They don't wait in college golf. Chris Stiles, after making that birdie at 17, already go. To go on the tee at 18.
Yeah, good looking line here. Needs to get up just a bit.
Should stay, I think. No. Literally a yard from staying on top.
Yeah, maybe less than that.
Might have half a foot
good
left.
In the air.
Right club.
There's got to be a worn-out track to the hole from there.
Like, there's no doubt there
like
is.
Like a funnel.
Disappointing day for Sean Yu. Remember, he lost in a playoff for the individual last year. Top Tracer technology powered by Top Golf will follow the tee shot of Sean Yu here at 18.
Yeah, taking a pretty direct line at the flag here. 168 yards. Comes up short. I got to think there, the reason that ball came up short, Kurt, because the temperature's gradually dropping, the ball just not flying as far.
Could be. He went to the pullover here not too long ago, so once it starts cooling off, the ball's not going to go quite as far.
Yuki Moriyama will be next to play, and Kurt, I mean, after that 3-putt mistake at 16.
Aim up, Cal.
Huh?
Aim up, Cal.
Yeah, just a little left that ball.
That was an important par-saving putt at 17 for him.
It was.
Psychologically.
It doesn't take long to chip away at that confidence that you have. He's played a really nice round of golf today, just trying to get it in now.
Moriyama, from direction from head coach Casey Martin, I'm going to send that out to the right.
Oh, boy. This could be trouble.
Yes.
Well, Bob Papa's rental car right there took a shot. And that is an out-of-bounds stake. So
Kurt, it's a downhill 168-yard shot, but knowing that you have to be so precise to get it close just can get in your head.
Well, I mean, that's the ultimate mistake, obviously. That ball went a long way because he had a big pull hook.
Comes up short.
He saw his teammate hit it, you know, and fly everything and go long left. He probably went for one less.
Moment ago, USC's Cameron Henry, his second at the par 4, 17th. Good angle from up there.
Like he's trying to drive one in low, Burko. Skip it back there with some spin.
Go in.
Oh, oh yes, he did.
How about Cameron Henry?
Moriyama's shot on the way after his first shot went out of bounds.
This is going to end up in that spot we've been talking about all day. Funnel right back in there.
Over at 16, Callum Bruce playing his second.
A great angle from behind. You can tell how tough the angle is to get to that hole location on the right. And this is coming back off the green, I believe. No, it's going to stay just there. Hustle up. Mark that ball.
There you go. Speed golf.
It is right on the edge.
Cameron Henry doing a little repair work on the green at 17. Doesn't need a putter. When you can do something like this, Kurt, we've been waiting to see people take advantage of a tee shot up that left-hand side.
Yeah, that was the key. In the fairway, up the left-hand side, had a perfect angle. That was so good. Love how he drove it in there low with that sand wedge. Well done.
Grab that ball out of the hole. A little bit of a smile, wave to the cameras. USC making a run late on a Monday.
Welcome back to the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Titleist from Paso Tiempo Golf Club in Santa Cruz, California. 74th edition of the Western Intercollegiate. Number at 16, third shot coming up for Tyler Guo of USC.
Got it back in the stance, going to try to drive it into the hill, which we've seen already. Now let's see if it comes back around. Should. Very nice. He was kind of aggressive bumping it into that hill because he knew he had that backstop back there.
Way to go, Tyler.
Tyler's teammate Shane French at 15. Off that wonderful tee shot. He does. That's a birdie. That moves the freshman to one under par. Southern Cal now tied for second with a couple of holes remaining. Maybe they'll catch Washington. And let's go back a few years ago, 2015, the Drive Chip and Putt National Championships in the 12 and 13-year-old boys division. This was Shane French. What an experience for that young man. Ultimately finished tied for third, and it's just another one of the wonderful initiatives Augusta National and so many others have come together to collaborate and introduce these young men and women to the game of golf, and we're seeing it more often than not. We saw with Hideki Matsuyama a decade earlier, winning the Asia Pacific Amateur Championship, getting to play at Augusta National. Shane French had his moment at Augusta 6 years ago.
Really cool stuff. His style's long birdie putt. Boy, Kurt, we've earlier in the day we saw people putting from players from that part getting it up the hill a little bit more. I wonder if it's slowed down a little bit. We've seen a lot left short since.
Yeah, it's just a tough, really slow uphiller there at 18. This is Bruce for birdie at 16. Lucky it stayed up.
This is where Moriyama three-putted from, but a much better effort by Bruce there. But still some work. Keon playing his second shot at 18.
Yep, pretty darn good. That's the thing about Paso Tiempo, you know, if you hit a great approach shot in there and you stay inside that area where the hole location is and miss the ridges and the slopes away, you've got short looks for birdie. But if you just miss a little bit, you get punished.
Steve Sugimoto has a birdie putt at 16. Winner of the 2020 Fujikura Invitational, a six-shot win. It's got a scoring average of 72.33 this season.
What he did is he dropped the ball and it landed on his coin. That's why he was just moving his coin back to the original position there. I believe that's what that was all about.
back it up at 18. Chris Stiles for his par. So after that wonderful birdie at 17, Stiles with a bogey at 18. Finishes even par 70, but only three off the lead. Nice playing by the freshman. Sean Yu has this putt for par. Ranked 64th in PGA Tour University rankings. Does finish a tie for fifth. Opening day for Sean Yu, the runner-up in the individual last year, 6 over 76 today. His score, not a counting score, 5 of the 6 count. Well, not that long ago, Yuki Moriyama of Oregon was in a share of the lead. Then a 3-putt bogey at 16, and then his tee shot goes out of bounds here at 18, so this is for a double.
Freshmen make mistakes. You know, that's why they're out there learning. They're 18 years old and they're excited, playing great, and then they get up and they hit one off the map.
Good thing, though, is about being 18, short memory.
You hope so. Just be good up and down right here. Again, it's not one of those putts. See how little of a practice stroke he's taken there? It's not one you really want to try to hit hard in the back of the hole.
Bogey for Guyant. The group played that hole at 5 over. He finishes with a 1 over 71. Washington played earlier, and they shot even par as a team. Thought maybe Pepperdine would make a run at him. Hasn't been the case. That lead standing. Cal in second, done for the day at 3 over here at the Western Intercollegiate. Today's coverage is brought to you by Titleist, the number one ball in golf. Top Golf. Bushnell Golf and the new Wingman. Crank up your game. Senior Zihao Jin, second at 16.
122 yards just on the left-hand side. Trying to carry it up on the proper level.
Yeah, here's the spin, but
too much.
Yeah. Gonna stay. Oh, wow. I'm not sure how it stayed there. That is literally just a few inches away from coming back off that hill.
Z, how did that stay?
Oh, you're good.
Safe.
Yeah.
safe is a pretty apropos word. Cameron Henry on the tee at 18. Henry finished in a tie for fifth at the Western Intercollegiate the last time it was played in 2019. We take out our best moment of the day, and it's brought to you by Topgolf. There were so many choices, but just a short time ago, Cameron Henry second at 17. It was not only good, it was great.
Let's go!
In for eagle. Now at plus one, when you look at the lead, is going to be at minus three with two more rounds to go. He'd consider himself in the mix.
Definitely.
Yosef Gazel.
Trying to play a little slider in there. Yeah, this is going to use some slope.
Oh!
Wait.
Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Now stay.
What the heck?
Stay.
Stay. How about this?
Come on.
I mean, that almost went in, hit the flagstick, and he's going to have
a 50-footer.
50-footer.
Crazy.
That kind of sums up Gazelle's day. He's had a bizarre day. Almost holed it at 13.
Putt off the green at 11.
And nearly making an ace. And now. Hao Jin for birdie at 16.
Going uphill, a little slow. Whoa. Wasn't that slow?
So a par, but even Hao Jin is like, are you kidding me?
They need to bring in a rules official to repair the hole.
Yeah, I can tell you his teammate and also the USC players are laughing at that one as well.
Up at 18, Joey Moore, second.
Try to use that slope back there. Get out of the rough. If it gets out of the rough, it gets within 4 feet of the hole.
Now, how fast is that going to be?
Yeah. Extreme.
Do you have a smaller mark?
Green. Over to 17.
Yes. Putt's upcoming for San Diego State and USC. Looks like Callum Bruce, the senior for the Aztecs, will be first away. They've all got the three-quarter zips and sweaters out, Kurt. It's getting chilly.
I looked just a few minutes ago. It was 58 degrees out with just a touch of breeze out there, so it's a little on the chilly side now here late in the day.
Callum finished tied for fifth at the Cowboy Classic. Last time out for the Aztecs. Stroke average of 71.56 for San Diego State. So, again, one of those teams. Maybe keep an eye on come regionals and nationals. I think that win at Pepperdine's event to kick off 2021, that could go a long way for them, Kurt, that they took down Pepperdine, chased down Arizona State on that final day. Those are two of the four or five favorites to win it all next month. A
couple of really strong opponents there in those two schools, so it should help them. Should have given the team a lot of confidence that they could play with most anyone. And I'll go back to those conditions that they won in.
Brutal.
I mean, it blew 20, and it was in the low 50s, so the wind chill was mid-40s, high 40s. It was very, very tough. They have looked at this from every angle and talked about it. So let's see if they got it right.
Yeah, they should know.
Let's see if they got it right.
Getting some help from San Diego State assistant Evan Emmerich. Go back about 2.5 months ago. Westlake Village, California, North Ranch Country Club. 2021 Southwestern Invitational. And what a final day for San Diego State. Zihao Jin rolling in a birdie putt at 15. And it was Yosef Gazelle for birdie on 18 to close things out for the Aztecs. Heck of a final day, heck of a week. They're looking at their phones, seeing those scores update. They went back to San Diego with that trophy in hand. Awfully impressive performance. Sugimoto was part of that victory as well. His birdie putt on the way at 17, and how did that not curl in?
They have a lot of experience as well. Four seniors, two juniors on that team. They've been to this golf course a number of times as well. It should help them.
Cameron Henry for his par at 18. So Henry finishes with a one over par 71, deep breath, four off the lead.
His teammate Leon D'Souza for birdie at 17. Boy, no one seemingly has figured it out from left of the hole, Kurt.
We haven't seen a lot of putts made there, period, for birdie.
Back at 18, Yosef Gazelle, who nearly made an ace, has this left for his par. Yep, all you can do is shake your head after some of the things that have gone against Gazelle today. Washington, great day, even par as a team. They played earlier today. Cal in at +3, Pepperdine at +4 here at the Western Intercollegiate.
Back at 17, Callum Bruce spent a lot of time on his birdie putt. Still work to do to get in with four. Sometimes maybe a little too much into it, Kurt?
Possibly. I mean, it's all about speed on these Poana greens.
Aztecs led by head coach Ryan Donovan. We saw Evan Emmerich out there, the assistant helping as well. And you hit on it. Four seniors, two juniors, a veteran-laden team that, again, I'll reiterate it, watch them come regionals and maybe NCAA championships, a team under the radar to keep an eye on.
Steve Sugimoto on the tee at 18.
Promising. Well, look at that ball mark, almost right behind the hole, about 4 or 5 inches right behind the hole. Great shot.
See how Jin, second on the way at 17.
Yeah, trying to bring this ball in very high. It's 108 yards coming back up the hill, not a breath of wind right now.
Pretty darn good. Controlling it coming out of that rough.
USC's Tyler Guo on the tee at 18. Just two back.
Uh-oh. Not out of bounds, but it is down in that penalty area somewhere.
Over to 17.
Second shot upcoming for San Diego State's Puet Anupan Subsai.
Ball came out very low from that kind of a nasty lie there, playing safety out to the left. That was just 92 yards.
Now, Kaito Onishi from USC.
Wait, what do you mean 3 minutes? I didn't even look for it. I was waiting for them.
This is what he did a few moments ago off the tee with driver. Out of bounds down that left-hand side. We've seen a lot of balls end up right as well. Crossing the road. Maybe it gets a little ride unexpectedly down that cart path. An 18T is down there to the right, and this is picking up pace. You would think someone would have had a watchful eye on it because it's still going.
That's 18T.
There it is right there. Hasn't stopped yet. His teammates are right there on 18. So you would think at some point.
I think the group in front had already gone. And the guys he's playing with probably left their bags there. This is a terrible break.
Billy Ray, what's the update?
We have located the ball for Kaito Onishi. It's actually inside, just inside, out of the penalty area. So it looks like he's going to get a drop from this area, right? And it's going to have a very difficult shot. I mean, he is at the very base of the tee at 18.
Give yourself some bigger. There you go. Now go ahead and get your one club drive.
So the group on 18T ready to go, can't go. That's Leon D'Souza up there because his teammate's about 20 to 30 yards ahead of him.
Sure, that'd be great.
Getting relief after that cart path induced ride his golf ball took.
Well, very fortunate one to find it. It's, you know, we saw that our crack staff cameraman guys to pick that up, but I mean, this is ball is way down there. He's going to have a blind shot back over the penalty area over some trees, and he will not be able to see Kaito Onishi will not be able to see the flag stick here at 17.
Holes 363, Kurt, with the cart path and the ride it took, it went about 425 yards, give or take.
That's unbelievable where it ended up.
I can promise you he hasn't practiced the second shot from over there, and it looks like he might move out of the way, Billy Ray, for the group behind you to
Billy Ray,
a
you might want to turn around, Billy Ray.
We all got to get out of the way here, right?
Yeah.
Good idea. Billy Ray moves, and D'Souza ready to go at 18.
It's like a good swing. Oh, just a little too much left.
I was right there, Kurt. I could call this.
I was going to say, Billy Ray, you could call both groups playing for two holes.
Now, Onishi was very fortunate to, that ball was just outside the penalty line. And
up to a 3 pin.
Yeah, that's a 67 front. So that's like, what,
74 pin. But you got a shot.
This is. D'Souza.
Umbrella up there.
Just trying to figure out what's going on. This is a case, though, where the rangefinder made a big difference. There's no way he gets a yardage from over here. That rangefinder was huge.
If he can put this ball on the putting surface, it'll be a fantastic shot by Onishi here. It's back up the hill. Head coach JT Higgins said it was 54 yards, but it's back uphill, probably playing more like 65 yards. Needs to get out.
He still has a lot of work ahead of him at the 17th, does USC's Kaito Onishi. Maybe fortunate that he was able to get relief and somehow try to find a way to make his 4-2 in the house, leading the way. Finnegan Tilley, Justin Yen, 3-under 67 on the opening day here at Pasatiempo. A lot going on at 17. This is Puet Anupan Subsai for birdie to get to 2-under. Short one to stay 2 back as we go up to 18.
Third shot for Tyler Guo.
Watch the slope and the spin.
Just keep coming.
Now back to 17, the 4 shot for Onishi.
Now his 3rd shot, he chunked it and came up to this position here, playing his 4th.
Oh, would have been an all-world 4.
Yeah, big adventure here at 17.
Kurt, lengthy birdie putt for Callum Bruce here at 18. And it feels like as the day has gone on, these putts have come up shorter and shorter.
Well, it's not getting any quicker. The grass has grown a little bit throughout the day. The dew is starting to show up. So you've really got to give this a rip to get it all the way up there near the hole. Going to give it one more look to see if anybody else is going to play while he's getting ready here.
Going to be a good 10 feet short.
Stay.
Oh. Back over to 17.
Where Shane French also making a mess of the short par 4.
And hit this long left and made a mess of this. Now, difficult putt here for bogey. Wow.
Right, that hopped on him quickly, got airborne, so a double bogey 6. For USC freshman Shane French at 17, he's hot under the collar, 3 over his last 2. Needs to settle down. 18 doesn't get much easier as the sun's setting on a Monday afternoon in Santa Cruz, California. Make that early evening. USC stumbling. They were within 5 moments ago, now 8 back as we wrap up day 1.
Fourth shot for Tyler Guo, this a moment ago at 18. It's not going to stay.
Unbelievable. He was closer to the hole than Colin Bruce's ball at one point right there. Just caught a little different slope, I guess. And it is always bad when you putt and then have to go back to your bag for the sandwich.
That was a moment ago. Now his 5th shot.
Might turn around and come back. That's probably what he should have done on the putt.
So he'll have that for a 6. Make sure you join us for second round coverage of the 74th Western Intercollegiate. It all gets underway tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern here on golf. Callum Bruce for his par at 18.
Seen a lot of three putts here in the last hour at 16, 17, and 18.
Bruce four off the lead. Down to Sousa for par. Take it and run with that. Now Guo, who's accounting score for triple. Guo started this hole two off the lead. Needs to make this for a six. Final group waits on the tee at 18. Quadruple bogey 7 for Tyler Guo. USC a combined 8 over par on the last three holes.
You guys scoring right over there.
And they
okay?
have just fallen to eighth. Back on the tee, Puit and upon Supsai, ready to go.
After a long wait here, players watching back here on the tee at 18, all the ongoings up at the green at 18. 168 yards, and really right now, not a breath of wind.
So he'll have that lengthy birdie putt that we've seen so much, especially in the last hour or so. Let's take a look at Anupam Supsai, Mountain West Conference Player of the Year. Take a look at some of the notable winners of that award. Anupam Supsai, a winner in 2020. Second time in the last decade a player from San Diego State has won. Zihao Jin next to play.
This ball also headed out to the right.
And Curtis, as we've seen over, as I said before, over the last hour or so, that is no gimme as a two putt.
I mean, it's just so slow going that direction, but obviously much better than missing long left. These guys are just trying to make three and get out of here tonight. Turn it around, have dinner, turn it around, and come back out tomorrow and try to light it up.
Kaito Nishi, the 2018 Pac-12 Freshman of the Year. And Billy Ray, I know you're fired up about his game.
Yeah, it's fantastic. You know, it shows. I like his demeanor as well. All the ongoings at 17, got back up on the tee at 18, and kind of laughed it off. J.D. Higgins, head coach up here as well.
Onishi tied for fifth at the 2019 Western Intercollegiate.
The first time I saw Kaito was back in 2019 right here in the 10th fairway, and I said that guy's going to be able to play some of the best golf.
Shane French will have one of those lengthy birdie putts as the final group playing the 18th. Well, Justin Yen in at 3-under along with Finnegan Tilley, R.J. Mankey, Carson Lundell, and Carl Korpus. Just a shot back here at the 74th Western Intercollegiate. Let's take a look at the Top Tracer shot zone performance for the day. We had one go left in OB, and that last orange one, Kurt, I'm going to say that one was a shank.
The good, the okay, and the ugly.
Really cool look. The Top Tracer shot zone. Final group on the green at 18. Kaito Onishi playing his second.
Now, I expect him to use that slope off to the left and let it come back to the right here. Yeah, not too bad from that lie. At this time of night, a little dew setting in. This ryegrass around the greens becomes really sticky.
It's a big hole right there, too. Just right here, not the end.
Yeah. Well, coming up next, it's Golf Central, presented by Callaway. And then make sure you join us tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern for second round action at the Western Intercollegiate, presented by Topgolf and Titleist. And upon Soupsai, lengthy birdie putt.
Kurt, you've been watching this, I'm sure, throughout as the evening's pressed on, but there's a little moisture on the green. This has got to be really slow coming back up this hill.
You better take a pretty big backswing.
He did. Still might not be enough.
Upon Soupsai, one of 11 players in red figures today.
Sorry.
Yusuf Gazelle. He had an up and down day. Now Shane French for his birdie.
Yeah, coming off that double bogey at 17, trying to right the ship on this last hole. Not too bad from that position there. A ton of break from right to left.
And slow. That's close to the hole. Someone's gotten it here in the last hour from down below.
Zihao Jin for his birdie.
Got a great read.
You know, it's tough to make that adjustment, Kurt. Throughout the day, the greens have been so fast, and players become very defensive on the putts if you're out of position. To have to hit one so hard coming back up the hill, it's just hard mentally to get yourself to do that.
And they know how slow it is. I mean, you know, their coaches are telling them, hey, it's really slow going up there, but it's like that extra.
Can't believe it. I mean, that's a good 4.5, maybe 5 feet short. Maybe 6 feet, to be honest with you. Mm-hmm.
And let's face it, Kurt, these last four or five groups that have come through, it's about a 50-50 proposition as to whether this par putt's made.
Yeah, no, we've seen a ton of three putts. We saw a couple at 16, at least a couple. 17 was no bargain. We saw some three putts there, and now a bunch here at 18.
Hewitt and upon Supsai for his par. Okay. Well, judge there.
Well, young and very tough coming down the stretch. These last, these finishing holes, 16, 17, 18, are not easy finishing holes. And if you can play an even par, you're catching up and gaining a lot of strokes.
Zhao Jin for his par. Nicely judged. Six for Zhao Jin. USC teammates looking on as Kaito Onishi and Shane French will finish up. Onishi for his par.
Looks like he's got the Will Zalatoris set up here with the putter. Left hand low. It's not really, but that same grip with the right hand.
Yeah, pretty good up and down there by Kaito Onishi after that tee shot came up short.
Shane French for his par, and he finishes at two over with 72 today. It was not easy over the last 45 minutes for these groups coming in. Shane French with a 72. So 3-under leads the way. Finnegan Tilley of Cal. Justin Yen of Hawaii at 3-under. RJ Mankey just a shot back along with Carson Lundell and Carl Korpis. Take a look at the team competition. Washington's even par from earlier in the day stood up. California start 3 back. Pepperdine is 4 back. Stanford 8 back. It's the 74th playing of the Western Intercollegiate from Pasatiempo in Santa Cruz, California.